cows. I bet you never expected to watch a YouTube video about cows. Well, you're about to. Because cows are apparently more interesting than you ever could have expected. From a cow so incredibly muscular that it makes Arnold Schwarzenegger look like a pre-pubescent stick insect, to a cow so tall it could almost graze on the stars, these are cows you won't believe actually exist. Let's begin.
Huh?
Number 10, Belgian Blue Cow. This absurdly muscular cow is something of a milkable Thor Odinson. Just look at those muscles. This is a cow who could beat you in an arm wrestle. This is a cow that could beat you in any kind of wrestle. She is seriously jacked. She must have hit the gym pretty dang hard. Truth be told, this cow is actually a breed called the Belgian Blue. Now, while all Belgian Blues aren't as ripped as this one, they do have the propensity for it. The Belgian Blue's extremely lean, hyper-sculpted, ultra-muscular physique is something that's known as double muscling. Yeah, it's as hardcore as it sounds. This particular trait is shared with another breed of cattle known as Piedmontese. Both of these breeds have an increased ability to convert feed into lean muscle, which causes these particular breeds' meat to have a reduced fat content and reduced tenderness. Simply put, they look like they'd fit right in as a member of the Justice League. Number 9. Ankole Watusi Cow. The Ankole Watusi is a modern American breed of domestic cattle. It derives from the Ankole group of Sangha cattle breeds of Central Africa. But most importantly of all, it's got massive horns. Like the devil himself kind of horns. You do not want to mess with one of these guys. This is no ordinary cow. This is the sort of cow you'd expect to be featured on the cover of a heavy metal album. The Ankole Watusi may be a number of different colors, but is usually red, in keeping with the whole devil bovine vibe. And when we say the horns are large, we mean seriously big. The horns are unusually large, with a wide spread and the largest circumference found in any cattle breed. According to the Guinness World Records, a bull by the name of C.T. Woody, who you are seeing in photos now, is the record holder for longest horns, having horns with a circumference of 103.5 centimeters, or 40.7 inches. You seriously don't want a headbutt from him. Number 8. Belted Galloway Cow. The Belted Galloway is a traditional Scottish breed of beef cattle. It derives from the Galloway cattle of the Galloway region of southwestern Scotland. It's adapted to living on the popular upland pastures and windswept moorlands of the region. The exact origin of the breed is unclear, although the white belt for which they are named, and which distinguishes the breed from the native black Galloway cattle, is often surmised to be the result of crossbreeding with the similarly colored Dutch Lakenvelder breed. Belted Galloways are primarily raised for their quality marbled beef, although they are sometimes milked or kept for ornament. But what exactly is so unique about the Belted Galloway? Well, the clue's in the first word of their name. Belted. Unlike other cows, which have a blotchy splatter pattern, the Belted Galloway are almost entirely black. The one white portion of their body is a shaggy ring of fur wrapped around their middle. Almost like a, you guessed it, belt. Number 7. Highland Cow. The Highland Cow is a Scottish cattle breed. They have long horns and long, wavy, woolly coats that are colored black, brown, yellow, white, gray, silver, which is white but with a black nose and ears, or tan, and they also may be brindled. Highlands are raised primarily for their meat. They originated in the Highlands and Outer Hebrides Islands of Scotland and were first mentioned in the 6th century AD. The first herd book described two distinct types of Highland cattle, but due to crossbreeding between the two, only one type now exists and is registered. They have since been exported worldwide. They are a hardy breed, having been bred to withstand the conditions in the Scottish Highlands. Their long hair gives the breed its ability to overwinter. Have you ever been to Scotland? Do you have any idea how tough these guys have to be to tolerate those cold winds? Bulls can weigh up to 800 kilograms, or 1,800 pounds, and cows can weigh up to 500 kilograms, or 1,100 pounds. Their milk generally has a very high butter fat content, and their meat, regarded as of the highest quality, is gaining mainstream acceptance as it is lower in cholesterol than other varieties of beef. Number 6. Holstein Friesian Cow. Holstein Friesians, often shortened to Holsteins in North America, while the term Friesians is often used in the UK, are a breed of dairy cattle originating from the Dutch provinces of North Holland and Friesland and Schleswig-Holstein in northern Germany and Jutland. They're known as the world's highest production dairy animals. The Dutch and German breeders bred and oversaw the development of the breed with the goal of obtaining animals that could best use grass, the area's most abundant resource. Over the centuries, the result was a high-producing black and white dairy cow. Number 5. Armoricane Cow. A dual-purpose breed raised for both milk and meat production, what makes the Armoricane so unbelievable is its rarity. It's such an endangered breed that, shockingly, there are less than 300 remaining. Originally from the Brittany region and reportedly formed in the 19th century, the breed is said to have originated from the crossing of the extinct Pie Rouge de Carhaix breed and the Froment du Lion with the British Shorthorn stock. The result? The Armoricane. The breed first gained a herd book in 1919, and its name, Armoricane, was first coined in 1923. The breed was also fundamental in the founding of the Pie Rouge de Plains dairy cattle breed, as it was crossed with Rotbunt and Meuse Rhinisel stock. Populations of the Armoricane cattle breed were almost wiped out in recent years, with numbers down to 240 in 2005 and as low as 263 in 2014. The breed is now listed by the FAO as critically endangered. Number 4. Longhorn Cow. This breed is descended from a mix between a breed from Iberia and a breed from India, and they were some of the first cattle brought to North America by Europeans. The Longhorn is well known for, well, long horns. The horns can grow as much as 7 feet from tip to tip. Despite the intimidating horns, they are apparently gentler, kinder, and smarter than the average cow. I mean, when we say smarter, they're not gonna solve a Rubik's Cube anytime soon, but they're smart for cows. Like the Ankole Watusi, what makes the Longhorn notable is, yeah, the clue's in the name, the size of their horn. It is, to say the least, long. This breed is descended from a mixture of a couple of breeds. It's a mix between a breed from India and one from Iberia. They were first brought to North America by Europeans during the colonial times. Genetic analysis showed that the breed originated from the two ancient breeds listed above. They descend from the domestication of wild aurochs in the Middle East. Aurochs were an 85% Iberian and 15% Indian breed mix. They are direct descendants of the first cattle in the New World, America. Early reports suggest that they were first brought over by Christopher Columbus in 1493 to the Caribbean island of Hispaniola. Between then and 1512, more cattle were brought over by the Spanish and transferred to other parts of South America. Over the following two centuries, more and more cattle were moved north by Columbus and his fellow travelers. Number 3. Zebu Cow. Lumpy and bumpy in a different way is the Zebu Cow. Zebu are a type of cattle originating from South Asia. They have been developed into more specific breeds, and we'll get to one of those soon, but the umbrella breed is the Bos Indicus. This breed is easily identified by the prominent hump on its shoulders, as well as the dewlap or baggy skin hanging from its neck. Between the extra high shoulder hump and the extra low dangling neck, the profile is unmistakable. The miniature Zebu, seriously, they're tiny, dates back thousands of years. It first found home on the coast of southern India, where the climate enabled the animal to develop a tolerance to high temperatures. It's thought that the breed originated from southern India and also Sri Lanka. It's also thought that the breed remained small due to its original surroundings, with smaller animals better suited to living in a group of islands such as Sri Lanka. These closed environments led to a series of inbreeding, which caused the side effect of stunted growth. The breed is often referred to as Narudana in India, which means small cattle. It's thought that they are descendants of the Indian Auroch, like most other Zebu cattle breeds. They are also thought to be part descendants of the Sangha cattle breed. Number 2. World's Largest Cow. Holy cow, from some of the smallest cows in the world to the biggest. You won't believe the size of this bodacious bovine. At 6 feet 4 inches in height and 1,400 kilograms in weight, Knickers the cow is easily the largest cow in the world, and it's an absolute internet sensation. Technically a steer, not a cow, but hey, it's 2019, who needs labels? Knicker is a Holstein Friesian who lives in Australia. To give you a rough sense of scale, Knickers is around about double the size of the average cow or steer in his herd. Lucky for Knickers, its size may just be its saving grace. Knicker's owners say the steer is too big to go through a processing facility, so he'll live happily ever after on the farm. Which is good news for Knickers, but bad news for fans of beef. Butchers say that if a way was found to fit him in the processing facility, the giant would produce around 1,400 pounds of trimmed, saleable beef, enough for 450 cuts of steak and 370 kilograms of mince. Number 1. Miniature Panda Cow. And finally, we have a particularly rare cow. The panda cow is known for its markings that are just like giant pandas, right down to the dark eye patches. In fact, it isn't a panda cow if the markings aren't right. The white belt around the middle and distinct black eye patches on the white face. There are only a handful of these in the world, as somewhere around 30 in total. They're so rare that when one is born, it usually makes the news, and there's even a pair of miniature panda cows at the Woodland Park Zoo in Seattle, Washington. Cows come in many more shapes and sizes than you may have ever realized. Would you keep a baby miniature panda cow as a pet? Would you dare challenge a Belgian Blue to a fight? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.